FTV, what went wrong today?
What went wrong? What went right is the probably the
what
better
went right?
Question.
Yeah, actually, that is a better question. What went no? What went wrong?
What went wrong? We played a way that Man City would probably have liked us to play. So last week, Man United played against Man City at the Etihad. Man United played counter-attacking. Man United didn't care if they had the ball or not. Whereas with us, we kind of wanted the ball, passed the ball around in our half a lot. And Man City, obviously, they pressed or they set off together. Now, I think a lot of people get confused where, oh, Man City played this really high-pressing style of football. Today, they didn't press every time you had the ball. They only pressed when they needed to, but they did it all together. So if the ball's on the left, everyone's moving to the left straight away and they're going to go and press. Or if the ball's on the left for us, they might have sat and they might have like waited for us to come onto them. Now, again, that didn't really work. But the first goal, well, even the first minute of the game, they had kickoff. Kyle Walker kicked it out. It's our throw. Martinelli goes through, does a few kickups, has a shot. Edison saves it. That's the only thing Edison had to do the entire game. 45 seconds later, they score a goal. Game done. 1-0. What do you think? We're coming back from losing to Man City at home. Really? Yeah, so that's the first goal. Second one. What was it, 15 minutes in? De Bruyne again, you know, just pulling the strings. And yes, De Bruyne is a world-class, probably the best midfielder in the Premier League, centre midfielder in the Premier League. But if you allow him to do that, he's going to look 10 times better. If you allow a good player to be have space and, you know, not put pressure on him, he's going to love it. Third goal. So what, that's 3-0 before half-time. What was it, Phil Foden was running on the right, just passed it, and De Bruyne puts it in the bottom corner. Yeah? And then what, a minute after... De Bruyne has a shot going top corner. Leno saves it. Hits the post. So that could have been 4-0 in the first half. Game's done.
They could have had 6 or 7 today had it not been for Leno. Okay. And what, you know, the golf is frightening. For me, looking at that today, I'm like, this is Arsenal Football Club. You know, I don't know if you was around at Highbury.
No.
Right, I was. Too young. See us dominating teams. And now I'm looking on it and I'm like, that's how we used to deal with teams at Highbury. Yeah. And now, have we gone that far back that now that is us now? We're just ordinary at the moment. This is a very... And I know football goes in cycles. But this cycle for us has been going on for a long time.
It's dreadful. The two people that I was sitting with, they were saying it. We've gone from a top 2 team to a top 4 to top 6, now to potentially top 8 and even top 10. Now, that is... a downgrade in what, the space of 15 years? 15, 20 years? Which isn't, you know, great. But I know what you're saying. I've watched us, you know, Invincibles, whatever, playing the way that Man City play. Man City today, I don't think any one of their players took more than 3 touches at a time because they just move the ball so quick. They make it look so simple. They do the basics 10 out of 10. Whereas we can't even do the basics to a 6 or 7 out of 10. That was the key difference in class. Because obviously any Man City player would get into our team. All of them would, by an absolute mile. But that's not because, you know, like Aubameyang or Gabriel Jesus. Today, you'd probably have to say Gabriel Jesus has to come in because Aubameyang didn't do anything. But overall, you'd say Aubameyang's a better striker. So it's just, you know, on the day today, Aubameyang wasn't great. But overall, as a team, Man City have a... This is the thing. Man City have a plan. They're well-drilled. Pep Guardiola is a brilliant manager. He drills his team. On the ball, they do this. Off the ball, they do this. End of. That's it. No discussion. You're doing it. Us, we've got a supply teacher in charge. That's what it is. Yeah? I'm being deadly serious. We need a headmaster to come in. We need a new head coach to come and tell the team, this is what we're doing. End of. Go and do it.
What about, you know, a guy who's part of their setup at the moment is doing really, really well. What about Arteta?
No. I don't want a former player.
You're looking at the style of football and the play. He's part of that. He's in there. He's seeing that. Could he not bring that to here?
Not in my opinion, because so Mertesacker, for us, he's the assistant coach now. I don't know how that's happened. He was playing for us last season or the season before, and he weren't great when he played for us. He was coaching today in the warm-up. I got there quite early. I was watching the warm-up, yeah? It was Torreira. He passed it out to Pepe. Pepe crossed it in. Socrates and Chambers are trying to score, and Mertesacker's marking them. Why are you doing that? I don't get it. Why don't you get Socrates and Chambers to mark Aubameyang and Martinelli? And Mertesacker tells them, make the runs here or go and do this, or this is how you need to stand. I don't understand. Arteta, no, because he hasn't done it. Same with Lundberg. Lundberg hasn't done anything to warrant the Arsenal head coach job. Yeah, he's a legend for the club, but coaching-wise, managing-wise, he hasn't got the credentials, he's not got the requirements that we need. Because we need to be up here. Freddie Lundberg's down here. He has no experience. Now, that's not Freddie's fault, but he's been thrown into this, and obviously he's going to help the club. But we as a club need to sort this out big time. Otherwise, it's just going to keep going down. People are going to keep getting annoyed. People are going to keep getting frustrated. And we're going to keep having performances like this. Because at the end of the day, we want to be at Man City's level because we were at Man City's level. Maybe not 100 points or whatever, but we won the league without losing a match. Yeah? Liverpool might do that this season. I'm not saying they will, but they might do that. But Man City today outclassed us by a mile. Even in the second half, even in the game. Right, I'll ask you a question, yeah? Did Man City get out of first gear?
Probably not.
Right, so I think not they took pity on us, they just relaxed. Second half, I can't remember us even having a shot. Edison didn't have to do anything. I don't think he had to use his hands, to be honest. Maybe to catch a few crosses, you know. But Man City are smart. They're not just a good team, they're smart. Oh, I'm just going to take the foul, I'll take the yellow card, whatever. They had more yellow cards, more fouls than us, but they won a game 3-0. So how does that work? It's not like we were playing Sheffield United, even though they beat us as well. Mm. Oh, well, but we move on, what, Everton away next week. Mm. No confidence again. And again today, did you actually expect to win? Really? No. I said to my mum when I left, 3-0 to Man City. I promise you, I said it. Because why? Why would you expect Arsenal to beat the champions of last season when we can't even beat Wolves, Crystal Palace, you know, other teams that we've played recently?